Hi friends, welcome to our channel PVSK Education. This is the channel for you for all the technology updates, everything. If you subscribe to our channel, you will get the notification as a new videos, technological videos. And today we will start about healthcare management. So today we will going to know about the healthcare management. So healthcare management. So healthcare management, it is very necessary for everyone nowadays. Health is first, we know about the health. Health is very necessary for every person. A good health is first priority for the human being, for the development process, for economically, technologically development. So health is the absence of disease. Without having any disease, we will be good. This we call as a health. The Charaka, he also is a famous Ayurvedic physician in our the history. He gave this about the health. He gave some words about the health. Health was vital for ethical, artistic, material and spiritual development of man. That means he gave his, in his meaning, it is a key role it will place, and it is having natural creative skill and material substance, mixture of substances. It's spiritual development for human beings. And the Buddha also, you know, he said that one of all the gains of health or the highest and the best. That means among all the what you gain, earn the money, before that, health is the highest priority and the best one. So health is man's precious possession. So it shapes the destinations of the people. Without it, we can be no solid foundation for man's happiness. When a person will be healthy, he will be very happy. And according to the Webster dictionary, it defined the condition of being sound is body, mind or spirit, especially freedom from physical disease or pain. Without having any physical disease, pain, we need to free. When we will free from these diseases, we'll be very happy. Our spirit and health will be very happy. The World Health Organization also, according to that knowledge, it defined the state of complete physical, mental, social well-being, and not merely absence of disease or physical or medical weakness. Without having, when the person is physically, mentally, socially will be very good, without having disease, any weakness, we will be very healthy. This we give about health. This World Health Organization, according to that knowledge, it gave some divided some dimensions. According to WTO, some specific dimensions are there. These are the dimensions: spiritual, physical, mental, social, spiritual, emotional, vocational. All these are the dimensions we will see one by one. Physical dimension. Physical means it deals with the body structure. And physiology means it will normally the functions of human being, tissues, organs and systems of body, and resulting in harmonious functioning of the body. The sign of good health, or it's a good face, a clean skin, bright eyes, lustrous hair, well built with firm flesh, a sweet breath, a good appetite, sound sleep, regularly activity of bowel, and these are the body movements. All these functions, when it will be good, a person will be physically healthy, we will tell. And the next one, mental dimension. Mental dimension means it is related to the mind and functioning of the human. Without having any mental illness, It is a state of balancing between the individual and his self on one side and between the individual and his external environment on the other. Mental means without having illness you will be very good, mentally need to be strong. So it is the mental dimension. Social dimension. Social means he will be a person. Socially he will be, it is defined as a quantity and quality of individual interpersonal ties and extent of involvement with the community. He need to be socially good with the people. So it deals with between the individuals and the world which they live. Social health care is called as a socially will be good. And next one, spiritual dimension. Spiritual means it is a spirit of life. A man has a body and special senses. The mind has spirit of life. Spirit is a non-physical part. Spirit is the courage and determination that helps people to survive in difficult times and to keep their way of life and their belief. This is called, it's a spirit. In Indian culture, we call it is Atma, which is intangible. It is superior psychological one. Then, spiritual dimension of health includes integrity, means a good health, principles, ethics, the purpose in life, commitment, some other higher being and belief in concepts that are not subject to state or explanations. Means spiritual dimension, it's related to the mind, body, soul. Soul means the character and feelings, the perception, memory, thinking, all these were called, comes under soul. These all deals with spiritual dimension. And the next one, emotional dimension. Emotionally need to be a person when he will be emotionally strong. When a person healthy mind is one that expresses the right emotions at the right time in a controlled form. The illness, emotional disturbances are expressed in certain forms like anxiety, depression and mood swings, etc. All these, when these all will be in control, we call emotional, these be strong. In short, mental dimensions deals with cognitive, means study of mind, how we think, behave, while emotional dimensions deals with feelings. This is emotional dimension. Vocational dimension. This is the vocational means if a person and his job are made for each other, it can be said that he is vocationally healthy. Means he will be the choice of profession, job satisfaction, career ambitions and personal performance, all are important components of this dimension. A person is ultimately doing exactly with what they want to do in life and are comfortable with their future plans. This deals with vocational dimension. And next one, determinants of the health. So the health is multifactorial. These factors may be internal and external. So when these factors interact, the health of the individual or community would be affected. The following are the determinants of, this is the showing that health. Internal environment means a working environment, personal values, our desires, likes, dislikes, our perception of social norms, is all the internal. We are showing that external factors also. Many factors combine together to affect the health of individual and communities. Health or not, it is determined by their circumstances and environment. And the concept of healthcare. The main concept of healthcare is, it is an expression of related with fellow human beings. It's defined as multitude of services given to individuals, families, communities by the agents of health services or professions for the purpose of promoting the good health. Such services may be staffed, organized, administered, and financed in every imaginable way. But they all have one thing in common. People are being served. So this is the health care. This is the concept of health care. If you take in history of India, Charaka, he also gave that about the health care. In the Vedas also, they given Charaka, Jivaka, and the remaining all those, they gave that all this, how to manage this health by giving some medicine. And this is the concept health care. And the next one, different systems of medicine in India. So for every different ways for the treatment, so many treatments will give, different systems are there. Many we gave, many are there in India. So in India has incomparable rich heritage in ancient systems of medicine that make up a veritable treasure house of knowledge for both preventive and curative health care. From ancient days, we have so many health care managing. We are managing the health care. So, allopathy, Ayurveda, homeopathy, yoga, these are some treatments. We know allopathy is a conventional form of medicine. So, allopathy related to our being is a system of medicine that aims to combat disease by using remedies such as drugs and surgery based on the patient illness, infection, disease symptoms. Based on that, this treatment will give to the patients. Ayurveda, you know very well. Ayurveda means the science of life. It's in Sanskrit. It is the oldest and the best documented among the ancient system of medicine. The Charaka, he gave about the Ayurveda medicine. So, the next one, homeopathy. So, the system, while looking at the symptoms, while take into account the individual's mental, physical, emotional, and spiritual health before deciding the treatment. All these will take into account based on that, the give treatment for the persons. And the next one, yoga. You know, yoga is the technology of the practice of yoga is based on Patanjali's Yogesta. Medicine means this yoga. Meditation is an essential ingredient of yoga. It is associated with postures, means asanas, breathing exercises, which have wide and varied beneficial influences on both physical and mental health. So, by doing this yoga, physical and mental health will be very good. So, many people from ancient days and from now also in total world are following that yoga. These are the different systems of medicine. Not only this, many other is there. So these are the health from our Indian has great in this system from ancient onwards. Many people using some different treatments like this. So this is about the healthcare management. Thank you. Please subscribe PVSK Education. If you subscribe, You will get more update videos and new technologies. Thank you for watching video.